Hey traders, welcome back to another video. How many of you guys have probably heard before you should only risk 1 or 2% of your account at any given time? Well, I'm here in the office today, and today I'm going to be talking a little bit about how to actually do just that. How do you use the right position size? How do you find your lot size for your particular account? We know that risk management is so very important. And so what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna share with you guys a free tool that you can use that's basically gonna help you find the right lot size to use for your account based on your own personal risk preference. Let's say, for example, that you wanted to take a buy position here on AUD/USD. Well, let's say that you decide, okay, well, I've done my technical analysis, and if price decides to break underneath the lows, I'm gonna stop out, and I'd like to target something like, let's say this resistance level here, okay? So we've done our research, and this is just, again, a theoretical trade, but now how do we know that what we're going to be risking here on the account is only something like 2%? And what if we have a $1,000 account? What if we have a $5,000 account? Well, I'm gonna show you guys a tool that is super easy to use that's going to help you find this sort of answer, okay? So we've got our long position. Let's say that again, we're risking 91 pips here on the downside to try and make 193 pips here on the upside, kind of a swing trade setup. Well, now we need to know what position size do we take. And let's say that we have something like a $5,000 account. Well, what we can do is if you go over to Google and you type in lot size calculator, it's literally as easy as that. And you can see there's one here by babypips.com called the position size calculator. If you click it here, basically what you see is you've got this position size calculator. It is completely free. And all you do is you plug in your information here and it basically gives you what your lot size would be in order to risk the amount that you want to risk. So again, going off of, let's say that we had a 2% risk, and I think we said our account was $5,000, right? So we have $5,000 in our account. We want to risk 2% on this particular trade, right? Again, going back to our trade, we have a 92 pips, just for simplicity, a 92 pip stop that we want to have, but we only want to risk 2% of our $5,000 account. Again, risk management is key. It is a pillar to trading success, and it is so very important. So we need to have something like this tool, or at least a way to do this very quickly and easily. So we go back to the tool. We've got $5,000 as our account balance. We've got a risk of 2%, and we want to stop out at how many pips? 92 pips. All we do is plug it in, and then we can put in the pair. We can look for, let's see, AUD/USD. There it is. And then we just click this big fat green calculate button, and we're all good. Okay, so we're risking $100, right? Which makes sense. We're risking 2% of our $5,000 account, risking $100 on this particular trade setup. Now just remember also with this positive risk reward, something like a 2-to-1, that means just roughly we're gonna be making something like $220, let's say, of profit if we are correct about the trade. But that is a whole nother topic for other videos. Make sure you're subscribed already. If you are not, make sure to hit that subscribe button. I know a lot of you guys who watch are not actually subscribed, so definitely support the channel. We've got plenty of stuff here for free on the content side. So back to this concept. Now we click calculate, we're all good. We have a position size that is basically given to us. And you can see in terms of standard lots or position size, we want to have basically a 0.10 lot, or if you round up, a 0.11 lot size on this particular setup. And what that will do is it will give us approximately, because it's not going to be perfect just based on how it kind of plays out here, but basically we're going to take a 0.11 position, and that is going to give us roughly 2% risk, meaning that we're going to lose $100 if we are incorrect, and make something in the vicinity of $200 to $240 if we are correct about this position or correct about this trading setup. So again, it's just a easy plug and play. You basically just go to this position size calculator by babypips.com, and you can plug in your information. It will give you an approximate lot size that makes sense for your account, and you can go from there. Now, one more thing to add here is sometimes people say, well, Nick, what if I want to do something like a 5% risk? Which, of course, At the end of the day, I'm not telling you how you should trade. I'm just telling you my personal opinions here on this channel. I would not go so high as 5% risk on a particular position because it only takes a few positions to get your account very, very drawn down if you use something like a 5% risk. If you have, let's say, three trades that go bad in a row, suddenly you're at 15% drawdown. You lose two more and now you're at 25, and it's very quickly becoming a tough situation to deal with. So to me, I would use something personally from 1 to 3% at the highest of my trading account. Now, some of you guys will say, well, Nick, now I'm never gonna make that much money for my trading account. And welcome to kind of the reality, in my opinion, of trading is it's not a get rich quick scheme, and we can see it here in the numbers, right? It's showing us right here, clean and simple, that with the risk, a 3% risk would mean that sometimes you're gonna have tougher drawdowns and you're going to have to deal with that. So having something like a 5% risk, 10% risk, a lot of times traders, you see newer traders kind of making that mistake, in my opinion, because it only takes a couple bad trades to give you a very, very tough drawdown to deal with. And you can very easily blow an account if you are not careful. So something to think about here on the account, of course, is your risk percentage. You just plug in your stop loss and it will give you your risk. And then that way you can keep your risk reward relatively close or in sync with what your account balance is actually at. So if you have some more amount though in your account and you still want to risk, let's say you have $50,000 and you risk 3%, well now you're actually risking about $1,500 on the downside to potentially make something like $3,000, $3,500. Now you're talking a little bit bigger margins, and that's why it takes money to make money. I know that that is not a popular thing to say in the currency world, but I'm not here to be popular. I'm here to tell you my personal opinions about the markets. You don't see Lamborghinis here on this channel, at least not yet, maybe someday in the future, but the main focus is to stick to trading. And I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you very much. Make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. Give the video a thumbs up if you want to see more of this sort of content. Maybe share it with a friend so that they can also get access to this cool, this completely free tool. Thank you guys, and we'll see you next time.